Transporter number 2 will be used for the SLS program to take the launch vehicle back and forth to the pad. We will begin by going underneath the mobile launcher. We'll pick it up. We'll take it over to the VAB. They'll then assemble the launch vehicle on top of the mobile launcher. And then we'll come back to the VAB. We'll slide underneath it again. We'll pick it up. We'll take it out to the pad. A trip of about 4.2 miles. It'll take us about 7 hours to get there. But during our trip to the launch pad, we'll roll over a specially prepared crawler weight that consists of anywhere from 8 to 12 inches of special rock. Below that is limestone that's about 4 feet thick and compressed to hold the weight of the crawler and the mobile launcher. And then below that is some hydraulically compacted sand that can support all the weight. And then once we're there, we'll drop it all off. And a few days later, there'll be a launch. We'll come back, we'll pick the mobile launcher up, and we'll bring it back to the VAB to start the process all over again.
With 50 years and some 3,000 kilometers or 2,000 miles on the clock, NASA expects the crawlers to be in operation for at least another 3 decades. How cool is that? The latest refurbishment is complete, and preparation is well underway for the first SLS mission. Crawler will be doing what it was originally designed to do once again, which is moving rockets.
All right, guys, sometimes down in this ditch here, there's a gator, but as hot as it is here lately, they usually come out at night. when it's this hot. Alligators are cold-blooded animals. They don't like the heat, and they don't like to be real cold. So, but out the right front corner of the bus, you'll see both of our crawlers, guys. That's what we use to take the rocket assemblies from the VAB out to the launch pads via the crawlway. These crawlers weigh 6 million pounds. They go almost 1 mile an hour, and they get 32 feet per gallon of fuel. They have 8 sets of tracks. Each set's larger than the bus. Each set has 57 cleats, and each one of those cleats weigh 1 ton. This crawler right here has been refurbished and strengthened for that SLS. That's the Space Launch System, NASA's brand new rocket, the one that's going to go to Mars. Now, the mobile launch platform and 355-foot-tall tower for that rocket is in High Bay 3 of the VAB. We'll talk about that in a little bit. Coming up next, one of 3 mobile launch platforms that were built for the Apollo program and then converted over for the shuttle. This particular one was used 30 times. The first time was for that historic Apollo 11 moon launch. 50 years ago this year, folks, we landed on the moon. Up underneath that platform, you can see 3 large openings. That's where the flames from the rocket engines come through those openings down into the flame trench, which is built right into the elevated launch pad. Now, that mobile launch platform and tower for the SLS is in High Bay 3. High Bay 3 is the same high bay that the majority of the 135 shuttles, were assembled in. We're getting ready for the first test flight of that SLS. It's going to be in 2020. But out the right front corner of the bus, you'll see both of our crawlers, guys. That's what we use to take the rocket assemblies from the VAB out to the launch pads via the crawlway. These crawlers weigh 6 million pounds. They go almost 1 mile an hour, and they get 32 feet per gallon of fuel. They have 8 sets of tracks. Each set's larger than the bus. Each set has 57 cleats, and each one of those cleats weigh 1 ton. This crawler right here has been refurbished and strengthened for that SLS. That's the Space Launch System, NASA's brand new rocket, the one that's going to go to Mars. Now, the mobile launch platform and 355-foot-tall tower for that rocket is in High Bay 3 of the VAB. We'll talk about that here in a little bit. Coming up next, one of 3 mobile launch platforms that were built for the Apollo program and then converted over for the shuttle. This particular one was used 30 times. The first time was for that historic Apollo 11 moon launch. 50 years ago this year, folks, we landed on the moon. Up underneath that platform, you can see 3 large openings. That's where the flames from the rocket engines come through those openings down into the flame trench,
which is built right into the elevated launch pad. Now that mobile launch platform and tower for the SLS is in High Bay 3. High Bay 3 is the same high bay that the majority of the 135 shuttles, were assembled in. We're getting ready for the first test flight of that SLS. It's going to be in 2020. That crawler we saw will go up underneath this mobile launch platform, all 17 million pounds of it, take it out to launch pad 39B via the crawlway, all 4.2 miles for the launch. Now get your cameras ready, guys. We come around here, the door's not all the way open, but it's open far enough to see the mobile launch platform of this. You can't see the launch tower, but you can see the platform.
Level 26, 274 feet up, and I can see behind us, right over to the right, a newly added crew access arm attached to this mobile launcher. I want everyone here to meet Cliff Lanham, the mobile launcher project manager. Cliff, can you explain the significance of adding that access arm?
Sure. The crew access arm is one of the last major modifications to the mobile launcher in preparation for SLS and Orion. It basically will be the very last place on Earth that the crew will be before they're in the spacecraft and headed to space. Now, the weight room provides a contamination-free environment up next to the spacecraft, and as you suspect, it's white, hence the white room.
Makes sense. Now, how does the mobile launcher support the SLS rocket?
The mobile launcher provides fuel and power to the SLS and the Orion. It's actually the stacking.
That big black tower you see there has been there since the Apollo program. Has an elevator in it. That's how you get the astronauts, in this instance, up to the top so they can climb through that white access arm and on into that Dragon crew capsule. Also at the top of that tower, if you think about it for a minute, last bathroom on Earth is putting on their helmets and gloves. You can bet there were a lot of anxious moments in that white room. On all the way down to the right, you see the Boeing mural.
Thank you. there was something which was surprising to me. It occurred as I was standing on the surface, just after we had landed. I'd gone down, standing on the surface, and looking at planet Earth.
Mankind is about to leave his planet behind and journey to another. It is one of those rare moments when history is not being made, destiny is being embraced.
Thank you. successfully orbited the moon, and the astronauts returned safely to the Earth. I know. I'm Jim Lovell, and I was one of the crew of this spacecraft, Apollo 8. We were the first men to see the surface of the moon from just a few miles away. But it was the hundreds of thousands of men and women who worked on that team, and the millions of people who supported the mission that really made it possible. That way, I guess, we all went to the moon. Now, on the other side of those doors, you'll find an actual Saturn V moon rocket. It's still the most powerful, the most complex machine ever built. And I guess it's the only one that can take you to another planet. I actually got to fly one on a second flight to the moon called Apollo 13. But that's another story.
That's why I told you that's what you really want to get.